The organization's regional chairperson, Isaskar Chiandero, says that first-year students might experience difficulty learning on the internet unsupervised, and many of them in the region do not have access to computer and internet facilities.
For a student that was full-time, getting face-to-face time with the lecturer, going back now to virtual platforms, it's more difficult. So this is the reason why we are calling on for suspension.
Despite welcoming e-learning, the organization says continuing with lessons would disadvantage the majority of students who reside in rural areas with weak or no connectivity.
We all know that you are not allowed to go anywhere. So maybe they would have made plans to go to towns and download or type their things and submit. But in this case, how will they do it?
The Karas Regional Nanso Executive Committee further says that students receiving face-to-face lectures were not given enough time to familiarize themselves with the learning concepts on virtual platforms.
They should have informed learners of this, of the rolling out of e-learning, and given learners the time to grasp the online learning process.
The student organization also expressed concern that due to the state of emergency, hundreds of secondary and primary school learners who depend on the school feeding program are now without a much-needed meal. Nat Tangwijimi, NBC News, Kiet Manswap.